Good morning. Afternoon by now. 12:30. It's 33 degrees, something like that, Celsius. It's incredibly hot here. Trying to be comfortable on this steep angle here isn't happening. If I stand up and try to sit instead of sitting. But as soon as I stand up, I'm out of the shade. Got up at 6 in the morning. The other driver's been unloaded already and out of here, and they're just starting to unload me. Parked in that parking lot across the street there, but the yard is designed so tight to keep big rigs out. Going around the corner, I blew a tire curb. Just, they have really sharp curbs, and I blew a tire on a curb. So there's a Cal Tire like 2 miles down the road. I'll just drive there. Get a new tire put on. This is panel number 2 being lifted. Total of 12 panels. Hey, Jess is texting me. As soon as they lift one panel off, these guys right away get this panel ready to be lifted. So the problem is they're building it as they unload, right? So it takes forever. In the morning I was optimistic. They started unloading the first driver really quick, the first couple panels, and then it slowed right down. Yeah, they're beautiful floor panels, and the first thing they do is drill 8 holes in them for anchor points. So yeah, we'll see. Right after this, we'll go get the tire repaired or a new tire put on. And then they'll see what, I'll probably get dispatched to load somewhere tomorrow morning because it'll be too late in the day by that time to get loaded today. But I am optimistic I'll get out of here today, but you never know. 12:30 already. If it took them that long to unload the first driver, they might not unload me today. I don't know. We'll see. There's definitely going to be a lot more loads coming this way yet. I was looking at the blueprint. It's probably going to take 4 or 5 trucks per building, and there's 3 buildings here, so. I'll probably come back here again. 6 in the morning. I didn't go on duty right away. Got up at 6 in the morning. And I'm finally unloaded. I'm staying in this lane because it's on my left-hand side. Got the GPS sort of going there. Whew, it is hot. My truck is showing 39 degrees Celsius. It feels it. The AC is going full blast and it's not doing anything. I mean, it is doing it. It's better than having the windows open, but it can't keep up with this kind of temperature. Trying to find places to sit in the shade over there just to try to stay cool. And then I got a dispatch to head to Seattle to try to load today. I haven't punched in numbers into the GPS yet to see if I can make it there, and we'll see how long it takes them with the tire. back out. The guy at the tire shop saw what I was doing and said, stop the traffic and let me back up. I can't make the corner out of there. We'll just back out this way. Super helpful people there. So I actually ended up bending the rim on the work site where I just slowly crawled over the curb, but I guess it's a sharp enough curb and all the weight of the load, everything on the curb is enough to bend the wheel, so. It's been a Monday. It's now 3:24. My truck is showing 41, but we just started moving, so we haven't moved far enough to lower the temperature underneath the hood to the air temperature. So once we get moving, it'll probably drop to 37 or so. Although the guy at the tire shop says it was 100 degrees Fahrenheit, so I'm not sure what that is in Celsius. Or he says over 100 Fahrenheit. Yesterday calling the other driver, getting him to come around the other way. definitely saved him a lot of grief. And we called the other driver that drives this trailer as well, or the other driver, had a chat with the other driver. Well, I guess it was more like a conference call because I was there too, but it was on his phone. Talked to him and explained exactly how to come in here just in case he gets that load or later on in the week. Temperature now that we've been moving has dropped to 39. So yeah, it's hot. Oh yeah, car's cutting across at the last second. Drive me insane, because those are all high-risk maneuvers, high risk of accidents, and completely preventable. been nice to relax a little bit. As in driving rush hour traffic, but it was nice and relaxing. In AC, comfortable. I mean, I could have, while they were unloading, sat there with the truck idling the whole time with AC on, but that doesn't seem very nice to the company for fuel usage. And I got comfortable enough in the shade and light breeze. And we're closer to the ocean here, at least to a strait. It's definitely cooler here. It's 33 degrees Celsius. Turning the AC down. A couple of degrees makes a big, big difference. Time of day to be coming into Seattle. It's 5:54. What time did I say I was going to be here? I think I said 7-ish, but traffic's been really smooth, so. And GPS is taking some funny roads that I didn't take. So we're going to be there around 6:15-ish. 6:15, 6:30. Depending on traffic. Not sure why everybody's bailing out of this lane. On over here. Perhaps that's why people were leaving this lane. Oh, it's an exit only up ahead. I'm guessing with this kind of heat. Setting up for some thunderstorms in some evenings here coming up, because it's only supposed to get hotter from today all the way to this weekend, so would not be surprised. Turning off, but
nonetheless, it still goes from big four-lane road to small little two-lane roads. Like I said, I've got cruise control set. Minivan does not. It's still four lane here, but it's a bunch of narrow lanes. I'm not sure what's going on there. Might be off camera, but the car was doing interesting things. Goes the two lane over here.
Turn right at the traffic light.
Now it goes back to four lane, but this lane is turn lane only. Interesting. Notice how far back these cars stop? Have the stop lines way back there so you can make that corner with a big rig. I know I made a waypoint there. That's more like it.
1603 West, margin away southwest on the map.
I only got an orange flashing light. I was still going over, but I was got an orange flashing light. Everybody else got a red flashing light.
Construction was reported on Dalridge Way Southwest.
All right, guys, we're gonna call it a day here as I pull into the yard. So thank you guys for watching. Super appreciate all the support you guys give me. I might be stuck here overnight. We'll see if I get loaded and out of here. if I get out of here, I'll shoot a bonus video. But those of you that are YouTube members have already seen that bonus video if I did get out of here. If you guys want to see the bonus video as well, you can get in as cheap as 99 cents a month. I do a bonus video every weekend. I try, don't get it in every single weekend, but I try to get one in every weekend. Sometimes more than one. But try to get at least one a weekend. And everybody else, cool. Thank you for supporting me by watching these videos. I think I want to be in this lane. And for commenting and asking questions and telling me your stories. If anything here reminds me of your stories, feel free to say anything. I always appreciate it. Oh, going 1 mile over? No, 0 miles over. I thought I was going 1 mile over, I'll be honest. I thought I was doing one over. Between 30 and 41 speed difference. That's a problem with having a speed limit so low on a road like this. You have people going so fast, so the closing rate is quite large. All right, I'm out of here. You guys rock. I'm just gonna concentrate on the roads because they get kind of tricky here. So you guys get the silent treatment the rest of the way. Yeah, you guys rock. Okay. I sure hope I picked the right lane. See a train anywhere. I heard it, don't see it. people are not in the right lane.
Turn left at the traffic light.
Get out of the way.